welcome to episode number 7, part 1 of Win Now Carolina. I have 2 more years to win a Stanley Cup with the Hurricanes. To be honest with you, I'm kind of pissed off at a few of my players' developments, at Jarvis, Jack Drury, just to kind of name a few. I think I have the list right over here. Let me just take a quick peeky peek. I thought I wrote it down. That's New York. Okay, that's the Rangers. Yep, Gunler, Drury, and Jarvis are all kind of on my shit list. So I'm kind of seeing if Nyquist, St. Denis, Haltonen, and Demers are all kind of good to go. I'm going to make sure they are all in my lineup. Just for the preseason, I turned the injuries off. Because fuck the injuries, I honestly hate. Okay, so Nyquist is on the top line with Aho and Svech. I'm okay with that. As you can see, the second line is Demers, St. Denis. It's probably Deneen. And then Haltonen. So, let's kind of jump right back into this here real quick and just doing the first 3 games. And this is usually where I say my next stream or whatever, but that is still kind of TBD. Next week's kind of a little wonky, so let's jump right on into this shit. Okay, let's do this. Like Chick McGee said, games don't matter, but the injury, or the games don't count, but the injuries do. So probably just going to play these 3 road games, and then we'll call it a stream. Play next preseason game. Play. CPU versus CPU. I think I want to start Samsonov, or yeah, Ilya Samsonov. So we're going to do this. Let's go edit lines and strategies. I hope it doesn't reset. I kind of want to see what Samsonov. Actually, you know what? Let's start with Kosa. I still have not seen a playoff game with him yet. So, CPU versus CPU. Boom, boom, and boom. Play game, boys. I told myself I have to change the setting before I started, and what do you know, I still didn't change it. Nice face. When the regular season starts, I will turn the injuries back on, just as a heads up. But just for the preseason, I'm turning them off.
Possession here in the offense.
could probably change Nietzsche's number back to 88, too. I think you've been really kind of impressed with Costa so far. He's made a couple of really good saves. I mean, Slavin got burned on that. Halton shouldn't have to cover back like that.
Other than that, James, it hasn't been possession time, and now they got to climb back into the game. Handles the pass. Handles it again. And he takes the feed. Blocked in traffic. Through center along the wing. Nice feed. And now he tries to get it across to Svechnikov. The Hurricanes take it along the wall. Fires it on net. Makes the save. Holmstrom's moving it ahead. Moves it around along the half wall. Slides the puck down low. Quick feed. He scores! On the one-timer, too sweet! The Islanders have now gone ahead by a pair here in the second.
Stretching out the lead here in the middle three gives you a little bit more flexibility on the bench. The coach can use his whole lineup.
Puck picked up by Slavin. Getting a little physical there with that collision. And he takes the dish. The Islanders take it along the wall. Quick pass across to Saint-Denis. On the attack along the boards. And the puck leaves the zone. And he takes the pass. Puck grabbed by Demers. Sent into the offensive zone. New York's got it behind the net. Receives the pass. The Islanders played along the boards. Carolina's got the puck. Smart defensive play here in the open ice. And a good solid hit on that play. Can't make the connection on the pass. There's back-to-back saves.
Really sharp. Never loses sight of the puck to make the second save.
Inching closer to the midway mark of the period. New York's been the better team here over the last few minutes, increasing their lead to two. Puck scooped up by Romanov. Slick feed. Poked away in the neutral zone by Teravainen. Sends it into the offensive zone. Handles the puck at the point. Moves it to the middle. Moves it again. Oh, great save right there on the play. Along the wing up the neutral zone. The Hurricanes gain control of the puck. Here they come inside the neutral zone. And they dump the puck in, and the forwards are going to switch it up. New York's looking to break out. At center ice now, he grabs the puck. Takes the feed. Moves it quickly over to Krejci.
The Hurricanes' luck stays poor. This shot hits the pipe and doesn't bounce in for them. They still trail in the game.
Carolina's got the puck along the wall. Now a quick pass to Krejci. Carolina's got the puck along the wall. Centering feed. Oh, and he comes up with a stop. Wedgwood's going to bounce on it, and he'll take the whistle.
He's usually a pretty conservative goaltender anyway, and so the opportunity to kill the play, he's going to take it.
More than half the frame has been played here. The Islanders are currently sitting in the driver's seat, leading 2-0. Oh, they probably want a redo on that. Here's a short pass to Krejci. Gets the full use of his stick on the poke check. Walks the line here. Krejci's taking a nasty whack, and that's going to draw a penalty. Let's see the call here. The Islanders are getting penalized for slashing. The Hurricanes will have a chance to get on the power play for the first time this evening.
And so they'll get their first power play of the evening. At the very least, you want to make sure you get pucks to the net, win some puck battles so you retrieve the puck. You just do not want on your first power play to have a poor one, because that can leak into subsequent power plays as the game goes on.
Under siege and finally grabs that one and covers up for a whistle. Aho's looking to win this draw on this man advantage here. The Hurricanes win the faceoff. Gets it out of his own end. A spirited battle along the boards for the puck. Moves it
to Nyquist. They go on the attack through center. And a stick in the lane ends that threat. Taken along the wall by Dobson. Retrieves the puck, trying to kickstart this power play. Takes the feed at center and moves forward. Picked up along the boards by...
Yo, Raymond, how you doing, bud? Hope you're having a good day. Hope you're having a good start to your weekend.
The Hurricanes gain control of the puck against the wall. Here they come up along the wing. Takes the pass. And that caroms right off the mast. Oh, and another big stop.
Great positioning. Once he makes that first save, he's got to be in position to make the second. Well done.
The Hurricanes gain possession along the wall. And now it's grabbed by Pavelski. Oh, what a chance, and it goes sideways. Taken by Pellick. The Hurricanes scoop it up along the boards. From along the walls, they're gaining momentum. Shot! Stopped by the goaltender.
And he came out and challenged him. Good save.
Carolina's got a hold of the puck. And a tenacious effort pays off as he comes up with it. Carolina's gained possession along the boards. The Hurricanes are in transition. Quick feed down low.
Raymond, if you're still there, I will be right back. I am kind of making a bagel right now because I'm not going to lie, I'm a little hungry.
Here's a chance to set up now. And there's a save. Carolina's got possession of the puck. New York's got control of the puck. And now they look to make something happen from the neutral zone. Puck sent over to Pulsers. And a little body contact on that play. Tried to get 2Q with it and loses possession.
Don't mind the idea, but it doesn't work. Now you got to chase.
Quick pass to Taves, and he scores!
I saw Jonathan Taves score out of the corner of my eye, and welcome, Raymond. I'm glad you're here.
Late in the second, how does that change things now, Ray? From their bench, it seems like they're...
Actually did some, did some thrift shopping. Found a bunch of plates for my place. I got to think about... like 11 or 12 plates for 89 cents a piece. I got a little water dish for my cats. I got a little toy organizer for Dylan's room. I got that for $17. I found a couch for... yeah, I'm making a bagel. I'm a little hungry. I'm a little bit of a fatty. A pretty good day. Spent the entire day with my boy. Did a recording earlier today while Dylan took a nap, but I am here now. Well, and when I say I'm making a bagel, it's like
here in the late goings of the period, the Hurricanes make their way back into the faceoff circle, still in search of another goal. Puck is dropped and play resumes. Approaching the final 60 seconds.
I'm like 10 steps away from where I'm making a bagel at, so. Me and my sister went to Culver's. Had a good day with my sister today, so that was fun. I traced the outline of my apartment, so I can kind of start planning on where I'm going to be putting stuff. So, yeah, it was a good day. It was a good day.
There's the buzzer. 2 periods down. 1 more to go. They always say 3 is the magic number. We've got period number 3 next.
Just a reminder, Raymond, this is only going to be the first 3 games. I got to be to work by 10 a.m. tomorrow, and I have a
45-minute drive now, but as you know, that is going to be a very, very limited time only. Probably about a month and a half at the most, I would hopefully say. So, yeah, everything's kind of coming together quite nicely. How's the vehicle situation for you? Did you get that fixed for you?
In the third period. Lots of time left in this period. It's 2-1. The Hurricanes get a hold of the puck off the draw. Off the left wing and into center. Makes his presence known on the ice. Holmstrom's got it on the offensive end. They fight for it along the boards. Scooped up along the wall by Aho. Slides it on over to Nyquist. He got all of that one. New York's got the puck in their own end. With some open space at center. Poked away at center by Svechnikov. Puck picked up by Pulak. New York's in transition. Oh, he got clobbered.
Man, did he ever. And to make matters worse, he's got a stick knocked out of his hands. Now he's got to go chase the twig down.
Along the boards, they battle for the puck back and forth. Barzal's picking up steam. Huge steal in his own end. Poked away in the neutral zone by Demers. Jumps it into the opposite side. Pushes it across to Faxa. Gains the zone from the right. With possession along the wall. Big save.
That's a heavy shot. It's like it's going downhill. But the goalie still makes the save on that one-timer.
Sends the feed in front. And that's stopped. And the puck's kicked free. Faxa's got it in the defensive end. The Islanders cross the blue line and are on the attack. Faxa's got it along the boards. Casa's going to hang on to that one for a whistle.
Quickly on top of that, James. He needed a cover there.
Still lots of time left here in this frame. New York's got a slim lead. They lead it 2-1. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw.
New transmissions are not cheap either. Holy shit. That's going to hurt the old Belfold a little bit.
Through the neutral zone, moving the puck along the side. Sends it in deep. Carolina's got the puck along the boards. Slides it up front. The Islanders get a hold of the puck in their own end. And that's knocked away by Slavin. Pass across to Teravainen. Throws it in. New York's going to play the puck from behind the cage. Great read by the keeper to poke it away. Quick feed down low. He says, let's get physical on that play. Sends it quickly to Barlow. Puts it on net, and he makes the save. Casas on top of the puck, and that'll stop the play.
Pretty conservative play here, James, as he covers it up to kill the play.
And we're moments away from getting back underway here with the puck drop. Off the draw, and a nice job locking up his opponent. Streaking into the attacking zone from the right. Centering feed! Oh, and they couldn't complete that. New York's crossed the line and on the attack. Dropped him in the open ice. Feeds the puck to
yeah, Raymond, how's that going? Any, that moving along or anything? Hope everything's good with that situation, too.
Really good positioning as he makes the stop from in tight.
Past the midway mark in this period. New York's up 2-1, and the crowd has been enjoying this one. Barzal's gained possession, and his great work inside the face-off circle pays off again. New York's got it in their own zone. Carolina's got a hold of the puck now. And he comes up with it. And does it again.
Quick reflexes. You make one, you make two stops before the puck is cleared away.
Holmstrom's gaining momentum.
Hey, if you get her, just be glad that you skipped the diaper stage and all that fun stuff. 4 a.m., 3 a.m. feeding, the teething at 2 months old when we didn't know what was going on, No, I seriously do wish you good luck with that situation, man. That's not fun, and it's probably not nice to deal with and think about. Because, as I know, the mind can be a very dark place.
Puck goes out of play. We got a face-off coming up. The Islanders win the face-off. Moves the puck on the half wall.
Sorry, James, that's a really solid hit there.
The Islanders will play it in their own end.
This is when you see guys starting to shake their head or squeeze the stick a little bit tighter when they go back to the bench. Plenty of chances at both ends of the ice. Nobody seems to be able to find a way to finish them off.
The Islanders play it along the boards. Quick pass to Aho. And that's broken up. Handles the pass at center. Here's a shot. How did he stop that one?
He gets out right in front of that puck. It's in the low slot. He keeps himself big. There's nowhere for the puck to find a hole.
Just here in the late stages of this frame, it's 2-1. And with the centers tied up, he swoops in to take possession. And skilled use of the stick to poke the puck away. Down the left wing, across into the offensive end. The Hurricanes gain possession. Along the side, here they come through the neutral zone. Puck grabbed by Pulak. Quick feed to Romanov. The Hurricanes go to work on offense. And he slides it quickly to Bouchard. And the traffic neutralizes that threat. And it's a quick pass to Hedman. And now he moves it quickly to Saint-Denis. Moves it to the middle. And that doesn't connect. And it's kicked away. Oh, that's poked away in the offensive zone by Hedman. Too many bodies in the way. Under a minute to go here in regulation time. Gaining speed through center, and here they come on the attack. Denied by the puck stopper. Wedgwood's going to slow things down and opt for the whistle.
Well, you got to kill the play eventually. That way everyone can get reorganized.
Looks like lineups are set. They're ready to get things back underway. The Hurricanes take possession off the faceoff. Down the left wing, they gain the zone. Into the corner. And they continue to fight for that puck along the wall. Moves it quickly over to Karavainen. Puck scooped up by Slavin. And now he angles it across to Pavelski. The Hurricanes really need a goal here. They pull the goalie and the extra attackers out. Moves it to Natchez. The Hurricanes carry it along the wall. New York's got the puck in the defensive end. Oh, and that's poked away in the offensive zone by Terabina. Here's a short pass to Ulsters. Still has possession. Moves the puck to Natchez. It is all over. The fancy stats crew, the analytics people will probably be looking at this one and say the science makes no sense here.
Well, lots of times it doesn't, especially in one game. I mean, it's a close game. It goes on a couple of plays, and even though they didn't have the puck very much, they found a way to win.
Another Islanders win and bring on the Yes Movement.
I love this chant. The building just...
Okay, I'm done stuffing my fat face. I want to start Samsonov because, I mean, 2 goals on 11 shots is absolutely unacceptable, Kosa.
Underway. Good stand up hit on the play. Battle ensues for that loose puck along the boards. Carolina's got the puck inside the defensive zone. And they'll dump it in. The Flyers have it against the wall. Through the open ice, they're picking up steam. Carolina's got the puck. The Hurricanes cross the line and gain the zone.
Like, are you okay with having a child at your house and being responsible? Oh, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Like, are you gonna be okay with that? Having a little one running around, having teenage boyfriends over. Okay, enough of this album. The sad thing is, if we put Drury, or Nietzsche, because he's right there, Gunler, or Slavin, Drury, or Nietzsche, not Nietzsche, god damn it. Okay, hang on a sec. I mean, becoming a quote-unquote, like, legal guardian or a dad, it's honestly a lot of fun. And that's what makes parenting worth it, bud.
The Flyers gain possession of their own end.
Like, yes, Petville. Yes, I am streaming. And you are still adorable. I'm going to miss you when I go. But
no, like I was saying, it's like, I don't think if I put Drury, Slavin, or Gunler in the lineup, I still think we're, I don't think we're better. I think I kind of made up my mind on what I'm going to do. Yeah, my cat Pavel. He's doing his rounds. Unfortunately, I'm not taking him with me. He's been at my parents' house for like almost 13 years. The other two cats I get, Riri and Rusty, I actually got them as emotional support animals, so.
Carlton's great at making accurate passes, guys. That's his tape-to-tape zone ability, and that's what helps him create scoring chances. I'll be watching these two players to see if one of them can really shine for their team tonight. Guys, back to you.
Penalty coming up here.
Rasmus Ristolainen. Dude, we're losing to a team that has Rasmus Ristolainen on it. I'm just saying, boys. But it's preseason. Doesn't matter. Games don't count, but the injuries do. Oh, Raymond, just a heads up. I ended up turning injuries off for the preseason. I don't know if you heard me say that or not, but.
Period has gone by. Hope you're enjoying this one. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. The Flyers win possession here in the open ice. Carolina's got a hold of it along the wall. Quick pass to Saint Denis. Moves it over to Slavin.
I step away for 1 second and we end up scoring a goal. Damn it. Always happens. And now that I'm getting cozy and comfortable, Philly will probably score 3. And guess who's back? You want me to just pick you up? Here, I'll just pick you up. Just please don't claw my balls, because that kind of hurts when you do that. Can you meow for the mic? Huh? Can you meow for the mic? Can you give me a nice meow? A nice roar? Give me a nice roar. Huh? Can you do that for me? There is cat hair flying all over the place. Holy shit. The basement door is open, so you can go downstairs and take a shit if you need to. Like when I put you behind the ears, don't you? Oh yeah, you're loving that. You are loving that. Okay. Raymond, between you and me, I think you'd be a good father. I really do. You seem to have a good head on your shoulders. I mean, you're a hockey fan, so obviously you're doing something right in your life.
Taken by Hedman. Carrying the puck.
Is it Devon? What is it? Oh, come on, Taves. Definitely not a problem, Raymond. I mean, you seem to be a hardworking guy. I mean, you go to work, you get the shit done, what you need to do, and you come home and watch me get my ass kicked in the preseason.
All right, that'll do it for the first period, and I'll tell you what, this place is buzzing. They're apparently giving away a car here in this intermission. We'll tell you.
Michael's got it? Oh, that was pretty, too. I think we traded Freddie Anderson for that pick. I'd have to go back and look. Oh my god, they got three shots and a goal. I think the sim just hates me. I think EA just hates me. I really do. I'm not gonna say the joke that I said yesterday, but it's implied. And Raymond, you know which one I'm talking about. Next game, I think I'm going to start Ketchikov. Let me see how he does.
Still early on in this frame, James and Ray with you. So glad you could join us. You can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. The Hurricanes move the puck in the defensive zone. And now he moves it to Nyquist. Nice feed from the left side up the middle. Moves it to Aho. Great poke check on the reach.
And Raymond, when I get a moving date, I'll message you.
Connect, not exactly an ideal pass,
let you know.
Quick pass to Pesci.
Man, I'm honestly, I know I probably talk about it way too much, but I honestly cannot wait. Like the great Linkin Park said, I want to heal, because I really want to start that process too. I don't know if I told you this or not, but when I do end up moving to Madison, I'm going to be disappearing from a lot of people's lives. Oh, I thought that went in the fucking net. Joe Pavelski was actually just recently in Madison. They had a Bob Suter Memorial game that they have every year. It's like a fundraiser. Brian Elliott was there. Tom Gilbert was there. Patrick Johnson was there. I think Mark Johnson even played too, I think. But I always have to work when that game is. I would really like to go to it sometime. And we got a fucking penalty, boys. Come on. Pavel, can I pet you? Raymond, how's your summer been going, bud? You've been enjoying it? Living life to the fullest? Come on, boys, let's kill this penalty off, eh? What do you say?
Slavin's a solid defender when he's the last man back in those one-on-one situations, guys. That's his shutdown zone ability, and he can really calm down those scary moments for his squad.
Carolina's got it in their own zone. Looking to break out here on the power play. Inside the offensive zone. clear the zone. The Flyers have it against the wall. Into the offensive zone. Moves it quickly over to Farabee. Carolina's penalty killers get a hold of it. The Flyers have it against the wall. Puts it on goal.
Yo, that's in the fucking net, buddy. Come on. That's in the net.
Nietzsche slides into the face-off dud, and they'll continue to try to kill off this penalty.
Oh, that's old Nylander. Okay.
Back underway as he wins the try inside the offensive zone. Moves it to Nietzsche. The Flyers get a hold of the puck along the boards. Philadelphia is ready to go on the attack. The Hurricanes have possession shorthanded.
Stepped out, cheated. I don't mean to kind of twist the knife because I really definitely know how you feel. But hey, Raymond, you're here. I'm proud of you. You made it through another day. Just like me. We're doing the best we can. And if you're tired, that's okay because there's a quote that I'm totally going to butcher, so I'm not even going to attempt it, but the reason why you're so tired is because you're just trying to keep yourself together, and that's okay. Okay, we were talking about that one, okay, I don't mean to bring up bad memories, because I don't miss Diane as much. I mean, I still love her to death, and there's nothing I want to do for her.
The Flyers have a hold of it in the defensive zone. Now over to Benson. Nice zone entry from the middle. Play whistle dead, offside the call.
St. Denis, a great skater who can turn on a dime, guys. His elite edges zone ability means not only can he turn quickly, but he carries that momentum into a new lane to create more space for himself.
Slides the puck across to Saint-Denis. Here's a chance and makes a save. Takes that pass back at the point. Great defensive effort with the stick. Farabee's lugging the puck. And now he passes it to Allison. There's an injection of energy with that hit. And the goaltender comes up with a piece of it to keep it out of the net. Here he is with the backhander. Puts it in for the go-ahead goal. Control the game now. You finally got the lead. You've worked so hard to get in front. Don't give it up now. The Flyers have taken the lead here in the second, but I wouldn't say it's safe.
Doesn't feel like it at all. This seems like a game that's going to go right down to the wire.
And he takes the feed. Puck scooped up by Nyquist. Quick pass to Svechnikov. Philadelphia's gained possession. The Flyers are on the attack. The Hurricanes scoop it up along the boards. Angles it over to Nyquist. Turned aside with a glove. Samsonov's going to opt for the whistle and give everybody a chance to breathe.
Sometimes you get running around as the shift gets long. This helps.
Past the midway mark of the frame. The Flyers are hanging on to this one-goal lead. They'd love to add another. Forster's won the draw. Unloads a shot! Tremendous stop by Samsonov! Fires it! And the lane's clogged up blocking that. Taken along the wall by Provorov. And now it's over to Forster.
Sorry about that, Raymond. My mom came home. The chit-chat. You know, I'm kind of starting to get worried about our goaltending situation. Like I said, I don't think we're better with Drury. I mean, Slavin can probably be a healthy scratch, but I honestly might send Drury and Gunther down. Who am I kidding? I do miss my wife. I can say that because she still is my wife, technically. Unless I got divorce papers waiting for me somewhere, which I'm pretty sure I do. It was funny, me and the guys at the rink, we were all kind of talking, because one of them, my coworkers, has somewhat longer hair. And we're like, oh, did your barber, like, something happened to your barber? He's like, no, he's like, I just haven't had time to get a haircut. Then my boss, Joel, was like, yeah. It's like my boss, or he's like, my barber ended up dying, whatever, so I had to go somewhere else. And then my other coworker, Ross, was like, yeah, it's like my barber got, she went out on her own and started her own salon. That's like, I think he said 40 minutes away. Hey, we just tied it up. Marty Nietzsche's, all right. And then I kind of look at him all, I'm like, yeah, my barber divorced me. So my hair's a little bit longer. But I don't care, because I haven't been able to grow my hair out since high school, so. But I know me missing Diane's gonna happen a lot over the next 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 months or so. Couple years, probably. Like I told you yesterday, that other thing is bothering me, so it's like I need to heal first. Hey, we both have 13 shots. Alright. He's Ray, I'm James, and here we go, period number 3.
And we are underway here in the third, still tied. Slides it quickly to Ristolainen. Turns that one away. Nice feed. Samsonov's got the pop. Boy, he's been under fire tonight. Been really sharp and in a close game.
Hope your summer gets better, Raymond. I mean, it'll be something to take your mind off of everything, you know, because you're going to be worrying about, you don't have to tell me the last name, obviously, but what is your cousin's name? They feel kind of bad just saying, oh, your cousin. If you don't mind me asking. Does that mean you won't be able to watch me get my butt kicked by the EA Sim? I'm totally joking by the whiny voice, I just want to make it seem dramatic. I know I don't have the camera up, so you can't really see my facial expressions. Hey, your summer will get better if, Emily, okay. Well, I wish you all the best, I wish you the best of luck with Emily. I think Emily will honestly probably brighten your layup a little bit and brighten your life up. So like I said, kids are fun. His name was Robert Paulson. Yo, that's fucking interference, bro. What the fuck?
Pass.
My summer is going to get better when I fucking move. But by the time I move, it's going to technically be fall. I thought they scored. Holy shit. Does Samsonov have a fucking Chicago Wolves mask?
We are all tied up in this one. Taves wins possession in the defensive zone. Carolina's got it against the boards. Sends it deep inside the offensive zone. Here's a short pass to Slavin. Sends it in on the attack. Battle along the wall.
Oh, I don't care. Hey, David Krejci, the old bastard.
Well, what a crushing goal to give up. But the other guys worked hard for it. They pressed the play, and now they've got the lead. Carolina's close to the finish line, and they've got the one goal lead. Keep pushing. You've got the lead, but don't let it slip.
Hope that didn't fuck up my stream. My stream wasn't interrupted for a second, was it there, Raymond? Good, because I the last three videos I recorded I left on my hard drive and I just remembered that, so I just ended up deleting them. And when I went to the file, whatever, it kind of popped up above in front of OBS. I think I just can't minimize OBS while I'm streaming. I think that's the case. I think stuff can pop up. No, don't you fucking dare. Especially you, Verona. Like, every team I've had you on, you've been a fucking disappointment.
Quick pass to Svechnikov.
Except for my Red Wings revenge tour. I'm honestly kind of considering trading you, if I'm being perfectly honest here.
We'll see how it turns out. Centering feed, and that's intercepted. Poked away at center by Besser. Nice zone entry from the left.
Your upside is Jacob. Whoever that Carly Bates is, I know I've said this before and I'll continue to say it, but they need to make that Jackie Redmond. They really do. I think she'd be so much better at it. That way it kind of brings a little familiarity. I know she's off doing a million different things. She probably doesn't want to record for a fucking video game. I just like looking at Jackie Redmond, if I'm being perfectly honest. Have a little crush on Jake. Oh, I thought that one. Have a little boy crush on Jackie Redmond.
Because at one point, the goalie totally loses where the puck is, but he stays calm, finds it again, and then makes the save. The Hurricanes have it now. Great hand by the goaltender, poking it away. Slick feed. The Hurricanes look to start the transition game. With some open space at center. Best defense is to play some offense as well. This is a smart play. With the lead, he dumps it into the corner. Now he can forecheck a little bit, try to kill some clock. Samsonov's got it.
2:22.
Jumped on it pretty quickly there. And like everything else tonight, he's really looked in control. He's had an excellent game. Here in the lane going to the frame, the Hurricanes are giving their fans something to cheer about as they lead it 3-2.
Damn it. Dude, I cannot wait for hockey to come back. I'll get my... You help me get my mind off of shit.
I gotta talk to Sean about see if he's doing a saver, because if he does.
Ouch! Oh.
Possession along the wall. Centering feed! And he'll hang on to it to regroup here for a moment. Philadelphia's got a hold of it against the wall. Here's a shot! And into the empty net. That should probably do it here.
I would think so, James. I mean, this turned out to be a pretty good hockey game, but once the empty netter hits, that seems to seal the deal.
Philadelphia's added to their lead with the empty netter, and Ray, that's pretty much all she wrote, I would say.
Well, you grind away to get the lead through this much of the game, and they pull the goalie, they're going to punch you. You put it away with an easy one into the empty net.
Samsonov's made his way quickly to the bench, and the extra attacker is now out on the ice. Final horn sounds, bringing this one to a close. I didn't mind the call pulling the goalie. They needed a goal, but it didn't work.
It's not going to work half the time.
Sorry about that, Raven. My chair just fucking broke.
Well, I mean, back.
Oh. Yeah, and I ended up, when I was on the ground trying to kind of process what happened, I looked up and I saw them score the... Oh, that's a bad goal. Who was... That wasn't Verana, was it? Raymond, who scored their fourth goal? Was it Jacob Verana? Oh, my ego's a little bruised right now, not gonna lie. Damn it, Jacob Verana. Okay, so that is two straight losses, the kickoff the preseason. Things are looking fantastic. You know what, auto sign? I don't give a shit. Bro. Okay, catch a cough, because I want you to play next game and I want you to be happy. Oh, I got a headache now. Holy shit. I'm only paying Kosta 3.2 and I'm paying Samsonov 5, so I'm paying my goalies roughly $8.2 million. That's not bad. Ketchikov, what do you want? This is the last game of the streams. Said it's gonna be a little bit of a quicker one tonight. I need to take some fucking Tylenol. Holy shit. Oh. Oh god. Okay. No, I want to bring up Ketchikov because I want him to start. Because, I mean, God, I hope it's not like last year, man. Roster moves. Can I bring up a goalie, or do I have to? I have to send someone down. That's fine. Jack Drury, you are getting sent the fuck down. Let's go catch a cough. Confirm. Best AHL lines. Yeah, my fucking chair gave out. I went to go lean back, and let's just say I didn't stop. And obviously, you guys heard the remainder of it. Or you heard what happened afterwards. So I'm going to give Ketchikov to start here. And I'm going to go take some time off because I have a headache now for a multitude of reasons. CPU versus CPU. Okay, we'll be right back.
Welcome back to EA Sports, everybody. My name is James Sabalski. The exhibition schedule continues tonight here on the ice. Really looking forward to this one tonight. The Capitals start with possession as we are now underway. Oh, love the defensive stick work there to poke that one away. Quick feed to Aho. On a good textbook hit there. Here's a chance in front, and he shuts down a great scoring chance there. Takes the feed in the middle of the neutral zone. Back to the point it goes. Makes the glove stop.
He's on it. Good chance, but he's able to glove that shot.
Hedman's able to steady his team defensively and still contribute points. Matthews has that shock and awe zone ability, which is when he dekes out the opposition, then ends the play with a quick shot into the cage. I'll be watching closely to see if one of those players can give their team the edge. Now back to you.
Now he takes it over the line. Solid hit on the play. Gains the zone through center. Almost lost the puck, but hangs on here as play continues. From the left side, they enter the offensive zone. The Hurricanes have it from their own end. Up the neutral zone now. Demers takes it through the middle of the ice. Lumps the puck into the offensive zone corner. Passes the puck over to Ove Kubel. They've got numbers here. Carolina's got the puck along the boards. Dumps it in. The Capitals gain possession in their own end. Gaining momentum along the wing. Kuznetsov's got it in the corner. In close. Big save by the goaltender watching that one.
Yeah, he gets out on top of the shooter. There's really nowhere for that puck to go.
Under siege and finally grabs that one and covers up for a whistle. Inching closer to the midway mark of this period. Still looking for our first goal. Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. Great reflexes as he comes up with the pad save. Carolina's got it in their own zone. Here we go, pucks in deep. Moves it quickly over to Person. And they'll be forced to regroup as the puck leaves the zone. From the right side and up the middle. Washington's got the puck in their own end. On the attack along the boards. Oh, excellent use of the stick as he knocks that one away. Whacks it into the offensive zone. The Capitals have it behind the net. Nice zone entry on the left side. There's a firm collision. From the point, they take control of it. The Capitals take possession in the defensive end. Shot! Oh, and he gets a toe on that one to keep it out.
It's a little bit of hope in this save. You hope you're in the right position. You hope you get enough of it because he didn't see it.
And tries to make a diagonal pass to Krejci. Shot! Makes the save. Kemper's going to smother it to get a whistle.
Can get dangerous if nobody's in control of the puck.
Here in the back half of this period, still no score in this one. Matthews has it in their own end. The Capitals will play it from the defensive zone. Moves it around along the half wall. Here's a shot. Glove save. Puck ready to drop here any moment to get things underway again. And sneaks in there on the tie-up and comes up with the puck. Good stand-up hit.
Hey, Raymond, I just sent you a picture on Facebook of the chair.
Take possession of the neutral zone. Along the right wall and into the offensive end. The Capitals scoop it up along the boards. The transition game now into full effect as they move across the blue line. The Hurricanes will play it in their own end. Along the wing up the neutral zone. Gets the puck in deep. The Capitals gain possession along the wall. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Washington's got it now. Moves it to Demers. Now into the offensive zone from the right side. Gives them nothing in front. Kemper's going to cover it up and get a whistle.
Even with the traffic starting to close in, he had to grab that when he did.
Off the draw. Nice job locking up his opponent. Takes the feed. Washington's moving it along the wing. Here's a short pass to Natchez. Poked away in the neutral zone by Kuznetsov. Carolina's looking to break out of their own end. And now he moves it quickly to Pesci. Shot! Oh, gets a pad on that one. What a stop by Kemper. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. Moves it to Protas. Quick pass to Bjork. Pass broken up. Takes the pass. And now he moves it to Pesci. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Here's a blast. And he gets in front of the slap shot to make the save. Washington's got the puck in the defensive end. DeLuca's got it along the boards. Sent into the offensive zone. Picked up along the boards by Protas. There's another consecutive save. The Hurricanes gain possession. Brings the puck into the offensive end now. Takes the feed. Here's a chance, sends it in front. And that goes off a stick and off target. Slides it across to DeLuca. From center, they get into the attacking area. Up along the wall on the right side and into the attacking area. And he passes it up ahead to Sutter. From the left side, they enter the attacking zone. Off a stick. There's the horn. Still 40 more minutes left in regulation time. We'll get to the second period right after this. Teams had a chance to recharge, and the officials set to drop the puck here on period number two. Still looking for the game's first goal as we are underway in the second. Well, this one underway Ray, give us an update on what your assessment is to this point.
You see this a little bit with teams that are evenly matched. It's the early game feel out where nobody really wants to take any chances, James. I mean, there hasn't been a lot going on so far.
Shot attempt completely fails on that. Scores! And look who's right on the doorstep, and he didn't miss that one.
Austin Matthews plays for the fucking Capitals. Holy shitballs. And yeah, thank you, Raymond. That did break right off. I went to lean back, and let's just say I didn't stop until I hit the ground, as you heard. I hope I didn't offend anyone with my language, but that fucking hurt.
James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. Washington's up 1-0. The Capitals win it. Launches it from the point. Denies the shooter on that play. Moves it on over to Demers. Carolina's got the puck against the boards. Oh, he'd like to have that pass back. Carolina's got it behind the net. Moves it quickly over to Demers. And he turned that one aside.
They work that puck around for the 1T, and man, does he hammer it. But the goalie just beats him clean on that shot.
The Capitals played along the wing. Moves it to Kuznetsov. Centering feed. Takes a blast. Here's a short pass to Demers. Washington's got the puck inside the defensive zone. The Capitals carry it along the wall. And he made the save to keep that one out of the net. Inching closer to the midway mark of the period. Washington's ahead 1-0. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Carolina's got a hold of it along the wall. Quick pass to Person. Carolina's got the puck. And a strong physical collision on the play there. Oh, they couldn't connect on the play. The Hurricanes gain control of the puck against the wall. And now it's grabbed by Natchez. Handles the puck. The Capitals take possession here in the open ice. Washington's got the puck along the wall. Denies him with the pad. Face-off looming as both centers get into position. And with the centers tied up, he swoops in to take possession. Quick feed to Slavin. Poked away at center by Kotis. Tosses it on to Svechnikov. Moves it quickly over to Nyquist. Poked away in the defensive end. Couldn't make the connection on the play. Here he is from the slot. Stones him in front. Kemper's going to cover it up for a faceoff.
While his team's ahead, he wants to make sure the pace of the game stays at the level they like.
Nice job tying up. Centering feed. Shot. And they continue to fight for that puck along the wall.
I am ready for bed. You probably are too, Raymond. Thank you for staying up late, too, by the way, to watch me. Appreciate it, man. Especially this 0-2. At least 2. I'm fine. My back does hurt a little bit, and I got a headache, but... But I did just pop some Tylenol. And before I go to bed, I can, probably take one of my anxiety pills. I take gabapentin for anxiety, but it's also a muscle relaxer, so I can take those about every 8 hours. And I think the last time I took one was, well, it was about 4. That's about 8 hours. I gotta start taking my meds a little bit better too. I've been kind of slacking on that lately. I think that's why I You kind of feel my mind slipping a little bit, but I've. Oh. Because, like, at first I was like. Because when I leaned back and, like, it didn't stop, I'm like, okay. I'm like, what's going on? Am I falling? And the next thing I know, like, the base is still flat on the floor, and I'm sitting on the. I'm sitting in the chair on my fucking ass. Well, not on my ass, but on my back. And the impact was probably what hurt the back a little bit. Not as bad as my ego. I did that live on stream. That was fantastic. Should have saw what time that was on the stream, so now I can go back and look at it.
In the final moments of this period, the Capitals have taken a 1-0.
Hour 24, hour 25. Fuck, if this could be like an hour and a half, it's probably going to be more than an hour and a half. But I'm just saying for upload time. Come on, boys. It's Darcy fucking Kemper. Guys, we need to do something this preseason because we need to start picking it up. And of course, to add insult to injury, I looked up and I saw that we gave up the fourth goal against Philly. That was fun. But to be perfectly honest with you, we've had this chair for probably fucking 15 years.
Got the puck against the half wall. Big is in position, and he makes a save. And now it's to Demers. Inside the offensive zone. Strong defensive effort. Moves it to Kuznetsov. Carolina's got a hold of the puck now. Washington's got a hold of the puck. Sends the pass over. Takes it at center. Here's a pass to the middle. And that's stopped. Oh, and that's poked away in the offensive zone by Kuznetsov. Denies him in close.
Smothered that in close chance.
Slavin's able to defend one-on-one situations so well because he keeps his cool, reads the play, and stays with his opponent, guys. That's his shutdown zone ability, and it's how he can contain the opposition.
Steps across the line and on the attack down the right side. Moves with the puck in the corner. There's a solid collision. Washington stays the line and into the zone. Here's a short pass to Bouchard. Looks to get the puck over to Teravainen. Manages to hang on. Fails to find the open man. Carries it into the offensive end up the middle. Moves inside. Couldn't find the intended target. Scores! They came, they saw, they took advantage of the rebound and scored.
EA, why do you hate me? Like, I am seriously, I'm not even going to say that joke. Never mind.
Still lots of time left here in this frame. The Capitals.
That's nice to look at.
Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Washington's got it along the wall. Moves the puck down low. And that's blocked. Oh, absolutely blocked him in the corner. And now it's over to Nyquist. Feeds the puck across to Svechnikov. Moves it to the middle. The shot. Too much congestion in front. Taken by Aston Reese. Takes control of the puck. Tries to make that cross-ice feed.
Even though it's a little boring, it's not boring. I mean, there's chances all over the place. Just nobody can find a way to finish it, whether it's a missed shot or a great save. Fans are loving it, though.
Hangs onto the puck. Taken along the wall by Matthews. Across the line along the left wall. Shot! And that doesn't reach the net.
Okay, I'm totally going to be like a teeny bopper here when I say this, but this stream has definitely offended me. Like, I am seriously offended by the performance that I have seen. The last two streams I have done, I have not won a game. We got swept by Anaheim, and we're about to go 0-3 in preseason so far. That's depressing.
Carolina's gained possession along the boards. Quick pass to Krejci. And he slides it quickly to Hedman. Big stop right there.
That's a good save there, James. It looks rather simple, but he gets the puck into the corner. No danger.
Puts it on net.
The sad thing is, Kachikov has honestly played. I'm sorry if I'm butchering his name for the Canes fans that if there are any that actually watch this. Like, I'm sorry if I'm butchering his name, but that's kind of how I pronounce it. I'm sorry. Kachikov.
And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Ferrari's lugging the puck. Along the wing. Washington's got it across the line. Shot! And a huge stop by the goaltender at point blank range.
Really good work. I like this chance here as
currently sitting in the driver's seat, leading 2-0. The Hurricanes win the draw, and he makes the save. Kemper's going to bounce on it, and he'll take the whistle.
He's usually a pretty conservative goaltender anyway, and so the opportunity to kill the play, he's going to take it.
Both teams gliding into position, and the official set to drop the puck. Pavelski's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone. Oh, it serves up a little too sweet with that save. And he comes up with it. In front, and a stoppage on the play as the goaltender covers things up. Carolina's won the draw, and they'll go to work. Kemper's on top of the puck, and that'll stop the play.
Pretty conservative play here, James, as he covers it up to kill the play.
Carolina's won the draw. Shoots it, and that shot dies in traffic. Came up with a nice save.
Yeah, it's a sharp save, James. Right in the middle of the ice, he makes the stop and pushes it away.
He tips it on the backhand. Stick save by Kemper. Takes a shot. And there it is. The final horn. Calgary's once said to me many years ago, show me a good coach, I'll show you a good goalie. There's a good one tonight.
The team looks good, and the goalie was great. The win that comes on the heels of a solid defensive performance.
And we are 0-3 in the preseason so far.
Well, listen to this place popping for the home team as they pay respect and homage to the home fans that pay their hard-earned money.
I think this is a cool tradition that started. I'm not even really sure if it's the last 10 years or so, but when I first saw it, I didn't think it would last. Now I'm like, it absolutely belongs. It's the right thing.
Thanks so much for joining us here. It was a fun one to call, and we will see you soon. For all of us here at EA Sports, stay safe.
I think I'm going to bring up, is Jarvis already up with the big boys? Is he actually playing or no? Is Jarvis in the lineup? I'm just going to do a little couple tweaks here.
that, I'm going to wrap up for now. That was not fun at all. I'm going to sim up to this game here, and then I'm going to call her a stream. So we got Ketchikov for two more years. Giannis has played the best out of all my goalies so far. And Columbus is 3-0. We're 0-3. So, let me just get my little notes here. As always, if you missed any part of this episode or any of the other episodes in this series, make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel, where I make playlists for every series, including this one. So if you want to binge watch a bunch of Win Now Carolinas, you can. But if you want to binge watch like the Chase or the Sabres build that me and Sean are doing, or the Win Now Sean, or the Win Now that me and Sean did with Edmonton, the Red Wings, the Spartans, the New York Rangers. I mean, if you want to watch any of those, you can. I try to label them as best as I can, obviously. Again, make playlists for everything, so if, like I said, if you want to binge watch, you can. You can just start at the beginning and go from there. Follow us on Facebook. When the NHL preseason resumes in a month and a half, the NHL scoreboard will be coming back for the preseason and obviously the regular season and playoffs. But nothing's really done until then. We're kind of in the dead zone for hockey anyway, so which kind of sucks. That's why I'm kind of streaming as much as I can to kind of get some hockey, fill some hockey voids for some people out there. When the NHL regular season commences, I will be doing Red Wings and Ranger game recaps. Sean will be doing at least the Colorado Avalanche, maybe the Buffalo Sabres. I got to talk to him about that coming up here pretty soon. When championship season rolls around, we will be doing the same in-depth coverage that we did this year. It was a lot of fun covering the different levels of hockey from college to pro and everything in between. Again, a lot of fun doing that. And then we also use Facebook for stream information, like sending the link out when we go live. And then if I was planning on streaming and I don't, and vice versa, I usually make an announcement on there. Twitter is only used for stream information, like sending the link out when we go live. And if we stream, if we don't stream. Raymond, if you're still with us, I thank you for your time. Thank you for staying up late with me tonight. Sorry we didn't get any W's. We thought we were going to beat Philly, but with Philly, we lost more than just the game. We lost our computer chair. So, upcoming streams right now are still TBD. I'll be honest with you. I might maybe do one or two next week. Next week might kind of be a quiet week. Just because my son's birthday, we are celebrating on the 11th. And then I also work all day on the 10th, for obvious reasons. Hey Raymond, you have a good night too, buddy. Thank you for sticking around. So yeah, I will figure that out, hopefully later today, because it is 12:22, so it's Sunday. One more day closer to getting my own apartment. Check back for Facebook on the, stream schedule for next week. Like I said, it might only be one day, it might be two, it might be kind of late, but, the week after that, it should be a little bit better. So, as always, thanks for watching if you made it this far. Hopefully we can make some changes here and get this team rolling again, because 0-3 is not good, but I mean, Columbus is 3-0, so I mean, what's that saying? As always, subscribe on YouTube, follow on Facebook, Twitter, Twitch, and Instagram, and I shall talk at you guys later. Thank you very much. Hope you all have a good night.